What's up guys and welcome back to the channel. Today I feature an innovative USB Type-C docking station from a company called Vobot. This is their versatile 7-in-1 docking station called the Vobot Mini Dock with smart display, custom apps, gaming emulator and more. So up next we look at what makes the Vobot Mini Dock different from other standard USB Type-C docking stations and a walkthrough of its smart innovative features. So that begins right after this brief intro. And welcome back. So in the box, you get the mini docking station itself, one USB Type-C to USB Type-C cable, a mini wireless gamepad, and a user manual. So for design, it's made of a plastic shell with an LCD display at the front consisting of a clock and a 2-inch ISP panel. For I/O at the back, it has one HDMI 4K 60Hz display port, one gigabit LAN port, one USB 3.0 port, and its power delivery 100 watts input port. Also illuminating from its interior is an attractive RGB display, and I'll show you how to adjust it in just a moment. To its left has two USB Type-C ports, and on the right has a computer connector that's also a USB Type-C port, a menu navigation press button dial, and a back button. And to its base has an anti-skid rubber pad. When you power on the mini dock for the first time, or if you reset its firmware, you first have to connect the dock to your router's Wi-Fi, or you can connect using a wired LAN connection if you prefer. So when it boots up for the first time, it starts emitting a Wi-Fi signal that you need to connect to using your mobile phone. You only need to select its SSID as it does not have a password attached to it. Once you are connected to its Wi-Fi, you will be given a URL that you need to open using your phone's internet browser. Once you have entered the URL, you'll gain access to the Vobot's Wi-Fi configuration page. Here, you will connect the Vobot to your home internet Wi-Fi network. Simply scan for your home Wi-Fi and enter your Wi-Fi password, and it will automatically disconnect your mobile phone from its internal Wi-Fi and connect to your home Wi-Fi network. So once you are connected to your Wi-Fi, whether it be at your home or office, this is when the fun begins. Firstly, on the ISP panel, you have a mini launcher, and using the dial, you turn clockwise to scroll up and counterclockwise to scroll down. To enter an app, you press down on the dial, and to exit or go back to the launcher, you press the exit button. Once I connected to the internet, I was prompted with a firmware update, which is a good sign for the brand to provide updates to fix bugs and improve performance. So the launcher comes with pre-installed applications. These include a Pomodoro application. This helps you concentrate, avoid procrastination, and complete tasks on time. You can choose to display a calendar. You can display the weather. This option will have to be configured using the configuration page on your mobile phone. If you are into trading, you can choose to display current stock trading information. If you are into cryptocurrency, it can display the current value of the top 4 cryptocurrencies. There is a to-do application where you can set up a to-do list and have it display on the screen as a reminder. If you connect it to your PC or laptop, there is a hardware monitor app that you have to set up and configure using the mobile configuration page. You have its settings area. There's an app called Now Playing where you can use the hub to view songs currently playing on your device. However, at this point, it's only compatible with Apple devices. There's a screen mirroring application to use the ISP display as an extended monitor when connected to your PC or laptop. And finally, there's a gaming emulator for Nintendo games, and I'll definitely dive into some gaming in just a moment. So those are the pre-installed applications, but you are not restricted to only those apps, as you can install additional apps, or if you are a developer, you can develop your own apps and install them. Let's now have a look at its firmware features. In the settings area, you have network settings. This is where you can configure in conjunction with your mobile phone the dock's Wi-Fi connection. Next, you have application settings. If you lost how to access the configuration screen on your mobile phone, simply scan the QR code and you will be taken to it. Under local is where you can select your time zone, change the unit of temperature between Celsius and Fahrenheit, and you can choose whether you want to display 12-hour or 24-hour clock. Under display and sound, you can adjust the brightness of the ISP display. You can change the RGB lighting effects from 3 presets, or you can turn it off. You can turn on sleep mode, and you can enable or disable the buzzer that works with the Pomodoro application. You have some miscellaneous options, and you can view its device information, perform a hard reboot, or reset the docking station to factory default settings. So that's its firmware features, but let us not forget that it's a USB Type-C hub first, which means you can connect it to your mobile phone that has a USB Type-C DisplayPort and access the phone's desktop mode if it has one. With a monitor connected to the docking station's HDMI port, you can complete your Android desktop interface. With the docking station, you can connect gamepads, mouse controllers, pen drives, and external hard drives and access them using your phone's desktop interface. You can also connect the docking station to your laptop, Mac computer, or notebook and connect a monitor to the HDMI port behind the docking station and achieve extended display. You can access controllers and storage connected to it and use its hardware monitor feature together with your Windows app to display the CPU and GPU status. There is one feature I could not get to work as it's still in development, and that is the ability to use the ISP display on the docking station as an extended display when connected. Even though the docking station has a buzzer, it does not have a built-in speaker to work independently as a Bluetooth device. Its gaming emulator is based on the Nintendo NES gaming console, and you can add and remove games using the same configuration URL used to configure all other settings. The emulator is pre-configured to the mini gamepad included in your purchase, and you only need to press and hold the power button and it will automatically pair to the docking station. One thing to note is that the ISP display is really small and can be difficult for persons with vision challenges. Also, it would have been nice to allow the games to be viewed on a monitor connected via HDMI. In summary, the Vobot Mini Docking Station, in my opinion, ranks as one of the most innovative docking stations to date. This compact unit delivers more innovative smart features than any other docking station, and they are just getting started because they have other products being launched. So if you like the Mini Dock and its features and would like to get one, then use the special link provided in the description below this video to take advantage of the early bird price before it increases. So with that said, I've come to the end of my review. Special thanks to Vobot for sending this amazing product for review. If you enjoyed the video, give it the thumbs up to show your support. If this is the first time viewing one of my videos, then be sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the notifications bell to be notified about open box deals, product giveaways, and when I release new videos. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Stay connected and see you in the next one.